I hate snow for many reasons. One of them being that I was planning to see this film originally Thursday night, the usual time that I go to the movies. But of course, there was a snowstorm, and so I, of course, didn't want to risk it. So that's why I'm reviewing it now, because I finally got to see it today. So let's get into it. Fantastic Beasts: The Crimes of Grindelwald is the sequel to Fantastic Beasts and Where to Find Them. And Fantastic Beasts and Where to Find Them is a prequel to the Harry Potter films. And Crimes of Grindelwald is a sequel to the prequel. And this film also stars Eddie Redmayne, Catherine Waterbird, I think I'm saying that right, and Johnny Depp and Jude Law playing Dumbledore. And this is a sequel where, you guessed it, Grindelwald is creating crimes. Not really, though, interesting when you actually think about it, but he's creating crimes. And so Newt Gingrich, which sounds like a Star Wars character, but anyways, he has to basically try and take down Grindelwald at any means necessary, along with a thousand other subplots. But I'll get into that in a second. First of all, let me just say this. I hated the first one. I really did not like the first Fantastic Beasts. I thought it was very bad. It was very boring. I fell asleep a lot during that movie. It was very, very dull. I mean, it was not able to sustain my attention at all. I think I gave it, actually, I didn't review it on my channel during that time, but I gave it like, I think a 1 out of 5. It was bad. But this film succeeds a lot where I think that film failed. The costume design in this film was really good. The makeup was exquisite. And the visual effects, for the most part, were really good. And I think it's because they were focused so much on the creatures and not like in a CGI extravaganza. Now, there were some scenes, and I'll get into that in my negatives. But for the most part, I thought they did a good job of focusing on the details of the animals. And because that, it felt more grounded. It didn't feel like a CGI blast in your face where you're just like, okay, I can't handle this. I also thought that it was nice having these cast members come along. Like Johnny Depp, I thought was passable, but it was nice seeing him like in a role where, yeah, he had makeup on and everything and it looked good on him. But to see him give a performance where, I don't know, it was more tame than the usual weird, quirky Johnny Depp performance. And I thought that him as a villain, he made some points that I thought were interesting. I mean, you know, I never thought I would say this, but he was a villain that, you know, he brought up some good points. I mean, I'm not going to spoil anything, but it was like, oh, well, you know, like, yeah, I can kind of see your points. And he wasn't like pure evil, you know, like Voldemort, you know. So I don't know, I thought he was interesting. Jude Law as Dumbledore, I think there should be more scenes with him because Jude Law was great. There's also like a revelation about Dumbledore that I found very interesting and I liked it. And it didn't feel forced to me, that is. But that's where the positives end. I have to say, this film, it is very busy. There is a lot going on. But it is also a very dumb film. A very, very dumb film. The opening scene really kind of like lets you know the type of film you're in for, where it had potential, but it's just, first of all, it was very hard to follow. The cinematography, I think, is really, really not that good in this film. There are some good shots, but there's a lot of scenes where it's just kind of like, wow, like, wait a minute. This is too busy. They're like, there's so much stuff going on, and it's not like cohesive. And it's a shame too. But there were some cool scenes though. You know, there were like the rain scenes and everything. But again, there was more negatives to the cinematography than positive, to me at least. I also thought the story was very, very, very convoluted. There were so many subplots. The character development really was not that good. You really didn't get to know that much. I mean, Newt, he was interesting with his whole, like, you know, choosing side thing, but it's like you've seen that before in the Harry Potter films. And I don't know. I think that this is definitely a middle-of-the-road film because you can tell that it's trying to appease fans of the first one, as well as Harry Potter fans and the lore. But it also is trying to set up a sequel. And I just think that this film, it didn't really warrant it because it just felt so lightly plotted and overly convoluted at the same time, which it feels like a juxtaposition of its own. But it's crazy just the way that it works because it doesn't work. So, I mean, and that's the thing. Like, this film, it is, technically speaking, it's okay. You know, it has some good things. But I feel very mixed about it. And part of me wants to give it a passing rating, but the other part of me is like, look, it has a bad story. Like, the story is really not good. The character development is severely lacking. It wastes a lot of potential, wastes a villain, because I mean, yeah, Johnny Depp gives it what he all like his all, but I mean, at the same time, it's like it's still a waste of potential. So again, I'm just very middle of the road. I don't think it deserves a hot sauce rating personally. Like, for me personally, Fantastic Beasts, you know, I think that it is a crime with what they did with Grindelwald, and I think it's just a crime that this is very middle of the road. So, me personally, I'll be giving it a 2.5 out of 5-star rating. So, no hot sauce rating. I think that this is a film that it had a lot of potential. It had a lot of material to work with. I mean, it's the mind of J.K. Rowling, for crying out loud, like the creator of the Harry Potter universe. But I just felt that there was a lot of magic lacking in many scenes, particularly in the second half. But I don't know. I think maybe not everyone can be Gillian Flynn, you know, Gillian Flynn, my mistake, where, you know, she's great at adapting her, you know, her stories into movies, like with Gone Girl. But who cares? I mean, at the end of the day, if you're watching this review, you probably loved the film, so it's fine, though. But guys, I mean, if you didn't like the movie, or you did like it, let me know your thoughts in the comment section down below. Also, what did you think about, you know, Johnny Depp's performance, or just the acting in general, you know, cinematography, all that good stuff? Just let me know your thoughts in the comment section down below. Also, don't forget the subscription, notification bell, and I'll catch you guys later.